Let's go over these two integrals. The first one, integral of sine x times cosine to the third power x dx. The second one, integral of sine squared x times cosine to the third power x dx. These two questions, which one's easier? First one, because I can just look at this integral and say that u equals to cosine x, and then du will be negative sine x dx, and then dx will be du over negative sine x. And then this sine x and that sine x will cancel each other out. And let me just work this out real quick for you guys. So the integral of sine x, cosine becomes a u, so we have u to the third power. And then dx is that, which is du over negative sine x. And as I said, this sine x and that sine x will cancel each other out. And then we can bring the negative to the outside. And the integral of u to the third power du, and of course you get the power rule backwards, right? So altogether you are going to end up negative 1 over 4, u to the fourth power, and u is cosine, so it is cosine to the fourth power x plus c, and this is it. And now let's take a look, how come that question is so easy? It's because we have a sine x outside, and we can cancel it out, outside right here, compared to cosine to the third power, okay? This question is going to be trickier, because you see, we have sine squared and then cosine to the third power. If you try to do this, here we have sine squared. I cannot cancel both of them. This is the trick. We are going to use identities for the square part, like either the sine squared or maybe something else. Okay, I'm not going to tell you yet at the moment. We have to refer back to these identities right here. We know that sine squared x is equal to 1 minus cosine squared x. But then, if you get excited and just plug in this into that, if you say sine squared x is 1 minus cosine squared x, and then if you do this times that, guess what? You have to end up with integrating cosine to the fifth power, and that's so much harder. We don't want that. So what should we do? This is how. I'm going to take a look of cosine to the third power. I'm going to break it apart. I'm going to take out a cosine. So that way we can do u substitution at some point. You will see. So let me just write it down right here. This is going to be the same as integral. I will keep this sine squared x. And when you have an odd power, what you should try, I'm just saying trying. Take a one out, and then you can look at this as cosine squared x times sine, I mean times cosine x. Dx, right? And you see, you have cosine on the outside. Just like right here, you have sine on the outside. I'm going to replace the cosine squared, and this is kind of replaceable, because when you have even power, I can just use this identity right here. This right here is going to be the integral of sine squared x. This is 1 minus sine squared x, and then we have the cosine x on the outside. Okay, right here, the product of the sines. Well, what good does this do? Let's see, this is the integral. I can, of course, distribute. So we are talking about sine squared x minus sine to the fourth power x, and then the cosine x is on the outside, dx. And then by the look of this, we are going to use u substitution that u equals to sine x. And then that will be able to cancel with this part, the cosine. Let's do it. So right here, I'm going to say u is equal to sine x. And then du will be cosine x dx. And of course, we can isolate the dx. We get dx equals to du over cosine. So this one, this integral here, is just integral of the sine becomes a u. So we have u squared minus u to the fourth power in the parentheses, right? That's the first one. And then cosine dx will, depends on how you like to do it, I like to just write down the cosine x. And then the dx is du over cosine. So let me write down du over cosine x. I just like to show you guys the cancellations. So now what? This is nothing but just the integral of u squared minus u to the fourth power du, And of course, we can work this out pretty easily now. This is going to be 1/3 u to the third power minus 1/5 u to the fifth power, and then we're done, right? And u is what? Sine x, that's all. So finally, this is 1/3 sine to the third power x minus 1/5 sine to the fifth power x. So that's it. That's C. Put a box right here. Done.